My dear friends, welcome to Rajasekhar classes on applied data science with Python. This is lecture number 476. In this lecture, I will continue my discussion on limitations of k-means. Before understanding this lecture, I request you to go through my previous lecture, that is 475. K-means tends to fail when you have clusters of different densities. This point I already discussed in my previous lecture. Similarly, there is a third problem which is called non-globular shapes, also called non-convex shapes. We discussed about what is convexity in our previous lectures. If you give this data without coloring, which data? This data. If you give this data without coloring to a kid, he would say, what he would say? If you give this data to a kid without coloring, he would say, this is one cluster, this is one cluster, this is another other cluster, isn't it? But K-means would say, what it says, this is one cluster, this is another cluster. K-means would not be able to recognize these shapes. Which shapes? This shape and this shape. K-means cannot recognize, isn't it? This shape is shape like this, K-means shape like this and like this. K-means would not recognize shapes like this and shape like this, isn't it? So this is non-convex, or I can say this one is non-convex, I can say non-globular, isn't it? If you recall the definition of convexity, first we'll try to understand definition of convexity. Just see, this is non-globular. The shape itself, this entire thing is non-globular. This is, isn't it? This and this is like that only I'm drawing, isn't it? Yes. What is convexity? What is non-convexity? Non-globular. For example, just if I take a point here, if I join them by straight line, some portion of this line, just see this part, it is going outside this particular region, therefore it is non-convex. In similar manner, if I join, just see, this portion is out of this particular region, isn't it? That's why it's non-convex. Similar manner, if I take point here and here, if I join, some portion of the line is outside this particular region. Therefore, all these are, I can say, non-convex. All these are convex. Take any two points in this region, join them, that resultant line lies entirely inside this particular region. Even if I take some circle, if I take these two points, join any two points in this circle, that resultant line lies entirely inside this particular region, isn't it? All these, this is convex, this is convex, this is convex, this is non-convex. If I take two points, if I join them, some portion is going outside. Here also, if I take one point, if I join, some portion will go outside, isn't it? If I take any two points, if I join them with straight line, that resultant line lies entirely inside that region. Then I can say it is convex. Otherwise, it is non-convex. This particular figure is non-convex. Otherwise, I can say it is non-globular. For which K-means is not applicable. If I take, what does it mean? This is something. If I take some point here, and if I take some point, if I join them, some portion is outside the region, isn't it? Yes, just see here, if I take a point here, if I take point here, if I join them, this portion will be outside this region. Therefore I can say it is non-globular, or I can say non-convex. Therefore, this particular figure is non-convex. So, when you have non-globular shapes or non-convex set of points, k-means tends to fail. For this type of regions, k-means tends to fail. K-means tends to fail. Isn't it? This is one of the big limitation of k-means. It typically prefer convex shapes. K means prefers convex shapes, isn't it? It prefers convex shapes. Outliers can make the algorithm go really crazy. Even a small set of outliers make the algorithm go really crazy. What are the ways to overcome these limitations using k-means itself? We will try to understand how to overcome. Let's go one by one. This is where you have three clusters of different sizes. Just try to recall what is this overcoming k-means limitations. This is where you have three clusters of different sizes, isn't it? Just try to recall. This is one size, this is another size, this is another size. One solution or one method that can be employed if you are constrained to use k-means only. Of course, there are other algorithms which might solve this problem. If you are continuing to use k-means, one thing you can do here is, instead of taking k equal to 3, instead of taking k equal to 3 for the same data set, if you can just increase your k, let me say k equal to 10, isn't it? For same data set, you know that there are only three clusters. Just say this is cluster 1, this is cluster 2, this is cluster 3, isn't it? But if you make it as k equal to 10, what will happen here is, you will get clusters like this. What are the clusters? You will get clusters like this, 10 clusters, isn't it? Now, clusters like this. If you take k equal to 10, you will get clusters like this, these 10 clusters. You will have to recombine. So, what you got is parts of a cluster. Just see, you are getting parts of a cluster. What you got is in figure. Just see, you are getting these parts, isn't it? You are getting parts of a cluster. This is one cluster. What is this? This is one cluster. This is bigger cluster and got separated into lots of small clusters. Just see, this one is separated into lots of small cluster. One solution is to increase k to get lot of smaller clusters, but then there is a challenge, which is you need to put all these clusters, you need to put together all of them. All these clusters are very close. Just see, all these clusters are very close, isn't it? And hence, I can group them. And hence, all the clusters which are close, I can group them. Just these clusters are very close. Therefore, we are grouping them, isn't it? We are grouping them, those clusters which are very close, isn't it? Which is not easy. So one, this grouping is not an easy task. So one solution is, find many parts of cluster, but we need to put them together, which is not an easy task. This is not a full solution. This is not a full solution. This is not a full solution to the problem. Again, how to find the right K? We will discuss in future classes, but this is one hack, not a perfect hack, but it could work in some cases. Similarly, when you have clusters of different, there is another problem, isn't it? When you have clusters of different densities, instead of taking k equal to 3, if you take k equal to 10, what will happen is you can get this one. What you will get if you take k equal to 10, you can get these clusters, isn't it? You can get, instead of k equal to 3, if I take k equal to 10, I will get these clusters. Means I will get 10 clusters, isn't it? You can get these 10 clusters for k equal to 10. Now, your task would be, again, group all these clusters into large cluster, which is again not an easy task. Hence, here again, you take k equal to 10. It's not easy, but it's possible. So k means is never perfect. Let's not forget the fundamental fact. Similarly, here again problem, grouping these small clusters into big clusters. But as we are saying, k means is never perfect. Let's not forget the fundamental fact. Similarly, if you have non-globular shapes like this, what would you do? Instead of k equal to 2, if you take k equal to 10, what will you get? You get lots of these smaller clusters, isn't it? And later on, you could come up with some other method to combine these small clusters into two large clusters. But it is not easy, by the way. At least you are not losing the structure. Here. That is important. If I take k equal to 10, you are not losing the structure. Earlier you are getting like this. This is one cluster and this is another cluster, isn't it? Increasing k and trying to solve it is not always the best solution, but at least ensure that points between two clusters don't get combined together the way we saw earlier, isn't it? Just see, earlier when we saw these are combined. Just see, this is one cluster, this is another cluster, isn't it? Again, k-means is not a perfect system. It's a good approximation and it does a pretty decent job in most cases. Eventually, clustering is not easy because there is no y-axis, there is no ground truth. All you are depending on intra-cluster and inter-cluster distances. I request you to go through this lecture. If you have any difficulty, please keep a comment. Thank you very much.